done over the math like 10,000 times. I don't know if I was just on the wrong line on the dial indicator, but now this looks like it's gonna work. The cut is 4175. So let's go ahead and cut this, and we're gonna go into 141,000ths, I believe it was. It's been long enough, I forgot already. In feed, 141,000ths. Back to the lathe. And kick the clutch in. Better. The gear. Let's change hands here. Okay, that looks pretty good right there, with the way that fits in there. If I were to roll a radius on this cutter, I think that would fit like almost perfect. Lot better than I can grind it anyway. So I'm gonna file that in till that drops right into that, all the way into the bottom of that tooth. Um, Yeah, so I'll do that off of camera because I'm not gonna be able to hold the camera slash iPhone and file this at the same time. But that looks, the way everything matches up there. Wait a minute. That dropped right in. Yeah, I'm gonna just cut a little bit of radius with the file on that sucker and get it to drop right in. And we're gonna go from there. So I'm gonna do that off camera. There it is. The gear cutter blank. I filed a little bit of a radius onto it, not super even radius. But it should be fine. I probably should have left it alone. I don't know. We'll see. So I'm going to pull this out, throw it in the mill four slots into it for cutting teeth, and first of all, I'm going to turn from that square shoulder right there, I'm going to turn that back on a little bit of an angle so we don't have a shear point right there quite so much. And so we have a little clearance to cut the gear that we need to cut. So quite possibly shouldn't have filed that round edge there, but we'll see how it goes.